Harifsa, the President of SEM India, Professor Venkatesh Raman, the Secretary of SEM India, all the speakers, experts, my colleague, Professor Umesh Deshpande, who is the organizing secretary of this event, and his team. On behalf of VNIT, I welcome you all for this 4 days event, SEM Compute 2020. In fact, we wanted to have you all physically on this campus, which is a green campus of 215 acres, and wanted to extend you the hospitality. This is a very good season here, lower temperature. It is a season of oranges. And I'm happy to share with you that around Nagpur, we have got many forest sanctuaries, and we wanted to take you there. But anyway, because of this pandemic, this is not possible, and this hospitality is due to us, and we'll have it somewhere later. The VNIT is one of the oldest technical institutions in India. It was established in 1960 as an REC, and then it has been converted to NIT, and in 2007, all these institutions are declared as the institutions of national importance by the Act of the Parliament. So we are one of the best institutions in India, and we are ranked 27th by NRF ranking. In fact, we are all celebrating our 60th anniversary. We are in the Diamond Jubilee year, and we are planning so many activities related to academics, research, sports, outreach activities, and other things. And one such activity is organizing this event, that is Compute 2020. At the outset, I congratulate the organizers for organizing this event here in VNIT. And I think this is for the second time we are doing it. In 2010 also, we organized the same event. While going through this the program and while discussing with Umesh, I found that there is a quite good effort to have interaction with the industries, then academia and the research institutions. This is what I found. And in fact, the applications of the computer science in a different fields that I think will be discussed over here in these 3 days, and the application in the education field itself, that is very important, which I found, because in the recent days, the pandemic, whole pedagogic technology is changing. There are a lot of things happening, and we found in the last few months, we are going for the online teaching and learning. And that is what we are also doing, and we are doing it reasonably good. But then there is a issue regarding the conduct of the examination and the evaluation. So that is a big sort of a, I will say, not a problem, but that is the issue which we need to address. Because if you go for the proctored examination, then there is the issue of the students, because in this national institute, the students are spread all over India, and they are having different issues, particularly the issue of the connectivity. And if you are going for the non-proctored examination and evaluation, it's okay. But then sometimes there is a fear that whether we are compromising to the sanctity, to the discipline, and to the quality of the examination. So these are some of the issues that we need to address. And I'm happy to share with you, as far as VNIT is concerned, we have quite adopted this online examination and online teaching and interaction with the students. In fact, for the final year students, in few months back, we have got a complete examination online, and more than 750 students, they appear for the examination without any problem. And then that was followed by for the non-final year exam students, who are about 4,000 students, we could conduct more than 500 examinations. In each examination, there was, I think each student was appearing for more than six papers. And so that is how 500 plus examinations and 50,000 plus evaluation of the papers. This whole exercise was there. And while doing this thing, we found that we need to have balance between this proctored and non-proctored examination. And this is not the end, I suppose, of the pandemic, and this effect of that will continue. And we'll have to find out different ways of conducting the examinations. And there may be a sort of a combination of online teaching, offline teaching, and maybe the use of the open book, open notes, discussion with the students. So that I think we'll have to use while interacting with the students and examining them. So this is a challenge. And I suppose that during this deliberation, some balance view will come out, and there will be some techniques which we can use particularly for the conducting the examination. And there is also another issue, and which is executing the national education policy, the new education policy, which in fact give the more thrust on the flexibility to the students and also flexibility to the institutions than multidisciplinary approach. So in this regard also, particularly for the flexibility, that is the multi-entry and multi-exit, then transfer of the credits, storing of the credits, and then again carry over of those credits. For all this, I suppose the computer science engineering, they can contribute a lot. They can make the system easy and adaptable to the institutions. And similarly, for the multidisciplinary approach, if some sort of softwares where all the people, they can come on one platform and discuss the things. These are the issues, I suppose, that will be deliberated during these 4 days, and something fruitful and meaningful will come out of this. I'm sure about that. With this, once again, I welcome you all for this conference, the international conference, and wish all the best and the success for this. Again, I'm feeling very sorry that we are not in a position to bring you to the this VNIT Green Campus. So that thing is always there, but I'm sure that in coming years, we'll have one more such event, and where you all will be there on our campus. Wishing you all the best. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Dr. Pramod Padole, sir. I'm glad to introduce our next guest, Dr. Jayant R. Haritsa, a senior professor in Department of Computational and Data Sciences and Department of Computer Science and Automation, IISc Bangalore. He has obtained his bachelor's degree from IIT Madras, MS and PhD from University of Wisconsin-Madison, USA. He has been a research fellow at Institute for Systems Research of Maryland, College Park, USA. He has worked as a technical staff at Lucent Bell Labs, Murray Hill, New Jersey, USA. He has worked with Supercomputer Education and Research Center and Department of Computer Science and Automation, Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore, India, since October 1992. He is an ACM Fellow, IEEE Fellow, and Life Member of Computer Society of India. We are honored by the presence of Dr. Jayant Haritsa. A very warm welcome to you, sir, and I request you to guide us with your empowering vision.
Thank you. Am I audible there?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Yes, sir. Okay. Thank you, Professor Deshpande, and all the other administrators at VNIT Nagpur. And good morning to all of the participants. On behalf of the entire ACM India fraternity, which you may be surprised to know, now boasts of 10,000 plus members. It's one of the biggest in the world. I'm really delighted that Compute 2020, which we have all eagerly looked forward to throughout the year, is finally underway. So as was already mentioned by the director, even though we are unfortunately forced to have it in virtual mode, this format also has its own advantages as the reach is now much larger. I am extremely happy to see that we already have so many participants in the audience. I think 50 plus or so. And I'm sure that this number will grow rapidly as we proceed further into the day's program. Education is a core activity of ACM. In fact, it is carved into the very first line of its charter itself, where ACM describes itself as a scientific and educational organization. Therefore, it is no surprise that we at ACM India view Compute as a flagship conference, and its focus on computing education lays an essential foundation for all our other activities. The mandate of Compute also fits in very well with the new educational policy, which most of you will be familiar with, and was recently announced by the Government of India. And it is a matter of pride for us that several ACM India members, as well as those participating in the Compute Conference, have played a key role in the formulation of this innovative policy, which is poised to completely transform the style of education within the country and make it go from a rote learning-based kind of environments to a situation where we actually have students being able to develop their creativity and intellectual skills within the formal educational paradigm. Also, as you may be aware, we have introduced 3 new awards this year, celebrating outstanding contributions in computer science research, computer science education, and by women. So please join me in congratulating Professor Sridhar Iyer of IIT Bombay, who is the first recipient of the Education Award. It is particularly apt that Professor Iyer, yes, so virtual hand clap here. It is particularly apt that Professor Iyer will be delivering the inaugural keynote later today on the very important topic of research into computing education in India. I would like to thank all members of the Compute Steering Committee and the Program Committee for having put together a very exciting 4-day program filled with interesting and thought-provoking talks that cover the spectrum from collecting field data to computing ethics to industry academia collaboration and to automated grading. And the automated grading is extremely important, as Professor Padole already mentioned, that because we have a new paradigm now, so many things would have to be changed into an online mode. And as you would see, both the proctoring, the way that people teach, the kinds of environments, the grading, all of this has to now have a complete new look. And hopefully the various ideas that come out in this conference will play a major role in impacting these policies. In particular, we owe a special debt of gratitude to Professor Viraj Kumar and Professor Venkatesh Raman, the PC co-chairs, who have worked tirelessly to provide us with this rich feast of topics. Both are also members of the ACM India Council, and they have ensured a smooth connect in both the directions. Finally, I would like to express our fervent thanks to the entire administration of VNIT Nagpur, which has played host to several ACM initiatives in the past and has unstintingly supported this event as well. Being from Karnataka, I am very happy that the institute is named after Sir Moksha Gundam Visvesvaraya, the patron saint of engineers in India, and who was also essentially the founder of modern Karnataka. Something that many people may not be aware of is that Professor Visvesvaraya's initial engineering education was not in Karnataka, because there were no engineering colleges at that time. It was, in fact, in the College of Engineering at Pune. And he studied in the late 1800s in Pune. He did his initial work also with regard to civil engineering in the area around Pune, and only then returned to Karnataka, where he finally rose to the position of Prime Minister of the state. So I always like to say that the foundation of modern Karnataka was laid in Maharashtra. Yeah, I'm sure that the people from VNIT Nagpur would not object to that. And if you go to the College of Engineering in Pune, you'll also find that there is a bust of Visvesvaraya at the entrance to the college. So I would like to thank Professor Pramod Padole, Professor Umesh Deshpande, and all the other organizers at VNIT Nagpur for lending us your facilities, your enthusiasm, your support, and your volunteers. And Professor Podole, we promise to come back soon for the oranges and interesting discussion on computer science. So with that, best wishes to the Compute Conference, and we look forward to an exciting 4-day event. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Dr. Jayant Hariksa, sir. It's an honor to introduce our next guest, Dr. Viraj Kumar. He is a research professor in the Department of Computer Science and Engineering at Dayanand Sagar University, Bengaluru. His primary research interests are in educational technology and computer science education. After completing his BSc from St. Stephen's College, MSc from IIT Bombay with Institute Silver Medal, and MS as well as PhD in computer science from University of Illinois at Urbana-Champaign. Dr. Kumar taught in the US for 4 years. At UIUC, he received the Rose Award for Excellence in Undergraduate Education. Based on his expertise in educational technology, he was invited to serve on 2 task groups of the Karnataka Knowledge Commission in 2014 and 2016. In 2017, he was inducted into the Technical Secretariat with the MHRD, now Ministry of Education, committee to draft the National Education Policy 2020. Since 2015, he has been an active contributor to ACM India and was elected to the ACM India Council in 2020. Since 2018, he has served as co-chair for ACM India's Compute Conference for CS Education. It's an honor to have Dr. Viraj Kumar with us today. A very warm welcome to you, sir. I request you to say a few words.
Thank you very much for that kind introduction. Thank you, Professor Padle, Professor Haritsa, for that wonderful introduction. So welcome everybody to this conference, Compute 2020 at BNIT. So on behalf of my colleagues in the program committee and the steering committee, I would like to thank everyone, especially all the members of the organizing committee who have helped us get this conference smoothly underway. So I want to just give you a few, a little bit of an overview of what we have in store for you. I'm delighted to say that this community is growing steadily, as was mentioned in the introduction. This is our 3rd year in this thematic conference, and it's bringing this much needed focus to computer science education. I think what I'll do is I'll just put my video off, because that's probably, I hope this is better. Thank you for letting me know. So what's particularly different about this year is, you know, our focus on basing these recommendations on research. So this is something that we are very, very keen on growing. And so much of the focus of this conference, each of the days, we will have something that is very, very specific around growing computer science education research in India. So let me just tell you something about it. So as was mentioned, we are delighted that Professor Sridhar Iyer, who is the recipient of the ACM India Outstanding Computing Education Award, is going to be giving this opening talk straight after this on computing education research in India. And then we will have Sridhar's former PhD student, Dr. Shidanshu, who is going to be leading this hands-on workshop. And I really encourage all the participants to take part in this, so that you have a very, very clear pathway to developing this particular line of research. It is something that we are very, very confident many, many faculty in India can do very successfully. So we're delighted that Shidanshu is going to be leading this. We have several talks tomorrow, which are very interesting, because we have established researchers in other domains in computing who have applied their research to computing education. And once again, this is something that we see as a very, very productive line. So those of us who are established in other domains can contribute to some of the major educational challenges that we face in the country, many of which Padale and Vince have also alluded to. One of the fastest growing segments of our community is actually involved in developing tools for education. And so we have several talks in that domain, including from authors who have submitted to Compute. And once again, we're hoping that by sharing these ideas, we can encourage others to contribute as well. And on the last day, we are delighted to share with you several multi-institutional projects that ACM India is supporting. These will help us conduct some very important studies. And we want to explicitly conduct these as multi-institutional efforts. So all of them will be led by a core team of researchers with experience in conducting such studies. And we are inviting each of you to participate. So please do take a look at the website. And on the 12th of December, the last session is going to be focused on this. This is an opportunity to get involved in some of these joint studies and hopefully get your research in this domain. We have, as was mentioned, a rich program with many, many important areas that we're covering in various keynotes and talks. So Casey Fiesler from the University of Colorado is kicking us off with keynote tomorrow in ethics in computing education, which is again an area which in India is very underdeveloped, but of course it needs to be developed. And Ricardo Cacefo from Brazil is going to be talking about challenges in teaching introductory courses with Python. That's tomorrow. We also have a whole session on various aspects of online teaching and learning, including assessments. So there's an exciting list of speakers on the 11th. The National Education Policy, we have a panel discussion on that, as well as a panel discussion on industry-academia collaboration. And of course, we have talks by all the various authors who have submitted and their papers and have gone through peer review. So we will have those on multiple days. Lastly, I would like to just mention that we have, starting at 4:30 every day, we have some breakout sessions. Since we have lost this opportunity to mingle with each other in a physical space, we are conducting these breakout sessions at 4:30 p.m. Those of you who are interested in some of the events for that particular day are encouraged to join us. We have sessions, so on December 9th and December 10th. I will briefly mention that Ricardo is giving the keynote address at the end of the day on the 10th, but then he has very kindly consented to stay back for this breakout session, because although he is talking about Python in the introductory programming course, he has also done some very good work, very related to what he is doing also for Java and C. So if your particular introductory programming course which then this is an opportunity to interact with him. On December 11th, we will again have on these two important topics, online teaching and learning, national education policy, the speakers who were involved in there, some of them kindly agreed to stay back and interact with us. And on the last day, as I mentioned, we will close with these multi-institutional research studies. And those of you who are interested in asking further questions are invited to join the breakout sessions. Please take a look at the program, and on behalf of the entire Compute organizing committee, steering committee, and program committee, I welcome you warmly to the conference. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Dr. Viraj Kumar, sir. We also have with us Dr. Umesh Deshpande. It's a privilege to introduce Dr. Umesh Deshpande, HOD, CSE Department, VNIT. He has done his BTech from VNIT Nagpur in 1991, MTech from IIT Bombay in 1993, and PhD from IIT Kharagpur in 2005, all in computer science and engineering. Since the last 24 years, he is a faculty member in the Department of Computer Science and Engineering, VNIT Nagpur. He is a senior member of ACM. I now request Dr. Umesh Deshpande to say a few words.
Thank you, Dr. Swati, and namaste to all my distinguished colleagues. So, respected Professor P.M. Padole, Director VNIT Nagpur, Professor Jayant Haritsa, President ACM India, and Professor Department of CSA ISC Bangalore, Professor Viraj Kumar, member of ACM India and professor in Department of CSE, Dayanand Sagar University, Bangalore. Professor Venkatesh Raman, who is the PC co-chair along with Professor Viraj Kumar, and he's from Indian Institute of Mathematical Sciences. Members of the ACM India Council, distinguished colleagues of the computing field from various industries and academic organizations, my colleagues of VNIT Nagpur, and participants of the conference. At the outset, I would like to extend a warm welcome to everybody to the ACM India Conference Compute 2020, organized at VNIT Nagpur, jointly by VNIT Nagpur and ACM Nagpur Professional Chapter. In the last few years, ACM Nagpur Professional Chapter has been involved in organizing some of the major events of ACM. In 2010, we hosted the COMAT Conference. In 2014, the Compute Conference. ACM India annual event in 2018, ACMW celebration event in September 2020, and now we feel honored to host Compute 2020. As Professor Pramod Padole mentioned, 2020 is the Diamond Jubilee year of VNIT Nagpur, and we started this year with a celebration in which a big bronze statue of Sir Mokshabandham Vishveshwariya was inaugurated, which was essentially donated. The funds were donated by the alumni of VNIT Nagpur. And the event was kicked off and inaugurated by Honorable Minister Nitinji Gadkari. To celebrate this year, as Professor Padole mentioned, many events have been organized, and the CSE department expressed interest to host Compute 2020 at VNIT Nagpur. We are very thankful to the ACM India Council for graciously accepting our request, and it's really a privilege for VNIT Nagpur to host Compute 2020. As Professor Viraj Kumar has mentioned, the PC of Program Committee of Compute 2020 has put in a lot of effort to chalk out an excellent program for the conference. I am sure all of us will be delighted to listen to the keynote addresses, talk by experts in computing education. We will also be able to listen to various seminars about experimental ideas being tried out by many researchers in computing education, and most importantly, the talk by the ACM India Outstanding Contribution in Computing Education Award winner, Professor Sridhar Iyer of IIT Bombay. We also have two integrating panel discussions, first on the national education policy and its impact on CS education, and second on the industry-academia collaboration. Prior to the conference, there was a workshop on algo dynamics on December 3rd and 4th, conducted by Professor Venkatesh Chopella and Professor Vishwanath Kasturi and the team of IIIT Hyderabad. The workshop discussed some interesting ways with which algorithms could be taught to the students. The workshop received a great response from the participants. We have also received a great response for the conference. The participation is from all over the country, and we are grateful to all the participants for their interest in this very relevant topic. I am also sure that they would definitely have many things to take back from this conference, and the discussions will definitely give a boost to their educational research and development activities in the future. I wish to state a few details regarding the organization of the conference. The conference is being organized as a webinar. So in this mode, the attendees will not be able to turn on their video or audio. So for posting questions, I request the attendees to please use the question and answer Q&A button. The speakers and the OC team will keep on looking periodically at the questions and will try to answer the relevant questions. Second is that a hand raise facility is provided, and if the speaker permits, we can unmute a participant to ask a question when the hand raise facility is placed out there. So as Professor Viraj Kumar mentioned, every day at the end of the proceedings, breakout sessions are scheduled in which many distinguished speakers will be discussing various issues related to computing education and computing education research. The details of the breakout sessions are put up on the webpage. The links for those breakout sessions will be shared on the chat box of the webinar and also over email. In these meetings, the participants can turn on their audio and video in order to have an interactive discussion with the anchors of those breakout sessions. So every day, I request the attendees to please use the link provided during Zoom registration to log in to the webinar. The link is the same for all the 4 days of the conference. The proceedings of the conference are being streamed on Facebook Live. The link for viewing the live stream is available on the conference webpage. So once again, on behalf of VNIT Nagpur and on my own personal behalf, I welcome everybody to Compute 2020. Thanks to one and all.
Thank you so much, Dr. Umesh Deshpande, sir. We will begin with the session by Professor Sridhar Iyer at 10:30. Thank you, everyone.